Cognito services. Now this is bringing in the untouched domain of application users. Now you want Amazon, or you can say AWS Cognito, give users an identity to interact with your web or mobile application that you have created in on Amazon EC2. It gives you, it creates the user or identity to interact with your web or mobile application which you have launched on AWS. So what you can do is you can create Cognito user pools where sign-in functionality for the application users will be added. You can integrate with the API gateway and application load balancer. You can integrate this particular service. So what happens basically, in your, there are two types of architectures in which we usually work when we are creating an environment. So it is two-tier architecture or three-tier architecture. When we design our application, we design it in this way, two-tier architecture or three-tier architecture. So when it is a two-tier architecture, then we'll be having two layers of my infrastructure. One will be the layer which will be front-ending the user. So we call it as user layer, or if the users are sitting over the web, then we call it as web layer, which contains my application server, which is actually my business logic. How, what application I have created for my business. That is your user layer. So this layer will receive the traffic from the user, and in the background, it will communicate with the database layer. So these are the two layers which are there in a two-tier architecture. And if it is my web application means my users are sitting over the internet to access this application. So they will hit my application. So my application has to sit in a network domain which can be accessed from the public internet. So if this is my public internet, that means the general internet. So my, this particular segment of network where my application is sitting should be publicly accessible, should be accessible by these users. So we call it as public subnet, the subnet which is accessible from the internet. So my application, or you can say the user layer, sits in the public subnet, which in the background communicates with my database layer, which is sitting in the private subnet. That means any user from the internet cannot log in onto my database directly. Any user cannot log in onto my server from the internet directly. He has to sit in my organization so that he can access my servers. So I actually protect these servers from external world. So this is a two-tier architecture. But good organizations do not rely on this. They go for a multi-tier or a three-tier architecture where they will have three layers. One will be web or user layer, which will just receive the traffic. Then there will be a business logic layer, which will actually do the programming, or you can say it is your application server, which is doing the actual task for your organization. And then again, the DB layer. So it is a three-tier architecture, which can be there. So Amazon says that the layer which will actually receive the traffic from the internet, will sit in the public subnet. Rest two layers, which are not accessed from the external world, they will sit in the private subnet. Both of them will sit in the private subnet. Maybe you can create a different network for your application servers and a different network for your database servers, but both of them will be private. So this is your public subnet. Now you understand the meaning of a public subnet and a private subnet. A subnet which can be accessed from the internet is a public subnet, and a subnet which cannot be accessed from the internet is called as a private subnet. Subnet means a portion of network. So if you have got a group of servers which cannot be accessed from the outside world, then they are actually private subnet people. If you have got group of servers which can be accessed from the internet, then it is known as a public subnet. So Amazon says that you can do it in a two way. One, you can create actual EC2 instances, servers over here, which will receive the traffic and will forward it to your application layer. An application layer in the background will then communicate with the database server. So this is how the scenario can work. Instead, you can, rather than keeping the servers itself, Amazon gives you an ability to launch a service called API gateway in this web layer. So it will be APIs which will be actually communicating with your application server, so that there is no 24/7 server which is required to run here. If it is an EC2 instance, the server will run for 24/7. But when it is API gateway, when the API is hit, the gateway is activated. It will forward the traffic to the business logic layer. Business logic layer will process it, reply back, and the request will be sent back to the user. So both the ways it is possible. You can keep physical servers in this public subnet, or you can keep an API gateway, application programming interface gateway also over here. Both the ways it is possible. So Amazon says that when you are logging into an application, you can create Cognito user pools for sign-in functionality for your application users, which can integrate with the API gateway and application load balancer. So the API gateway will receive the traffic. It will push the traffic to the load balancer. Load balancer will distribute the traffic between multiple servers, so that if one server goes down by any reason, your services are up and running from the another server. That's why we introduce the load balancer in between. So your user pools of Cognito can integrate with the API gateway and the load balancer to give you sign-in functionality on your application. When we were creating the IAM user, I have told you that you are creating the user for AWS service, not for the application. Okay. Now we are creating the application users in user pools of Cognito. And there also I can do the federated identity. That means if I want that my user should be able to log in into this application from his Google account or from his Microsoft account or from his LinkedIn account, then I can do the federated identity thing for my Cognito users also. So these users that we are talking about are my application users, the application which I have created on my business logic layer. So when the user has to log in into that application, The users can be created in AWS in Cognito user pool, or you can fetch the federated identity like Google, LinkedIn, where external identity provider will give you user pool, and you can use those users to log in into your application. That is what the Amazon Cognito service is. If you compare Cognito with IAM, IAM is your organization user who is using the services of your organization, whereas Cognito is your application user. It could be thousands of users accessing your application via mobiles. So it is your application user which you have created, which can be managed via Cognito, not the organization users. For organization user, I have got IAM, and for that, if I want to integrate it with external identity, it will be Microsoft Active Directory or LDAP as an federated identity. For my application users, I can use Cognito, and in Cognito, if I want to introduce an external identity, then I can have Gmail, LinkedIn, such kind of identity providers to create a user pool for me. So it could be a Facebook login, Google login, which can be used, which will help you to log in into your mobile applications. Sometimes you get to see an option, na? Login using your Gmail account. If you have downloaded an application in your mobile, and when you are doing a sign up of the mobile, you got an application option where you say that sign up using Gmail. So when you click on to that, the application communicates with the Gmail server. The Gmail server will check the username and the password of the user. If it is an authenticated user, then the user will be able to log in into the application. So this is what your Cognito service is. Federation means bringing in the third party. Okay, like this. This is a very perfect diagram. So suppose say you have created an application. Okay, the user via the mobile or desktop application tries to authenticate to access the services which you have created in AWS. So what will happen? For authentication, it will go to the user pool. If the user pool has local users created, well and good. If federation has been enabled, then it will go to either Amazon or Google or Facebook or Apple or XYZ for authenticating your user. Once the user is authenticated, authentication token will be given to the application. The token will be exchanged with the pool. It will be given to the pool. Pool will authenticate the user whether the user is able to log in or not. Here also, I can use AD for application login. We can use that user pools also for logging into the application also. If I want my organization user also to be able to log in into the application of my corporate. So there is an application created by us where if an organization employee logs in, then he will get different permissions. If an external user logs in, guest user, he can log in via Google, but then he will have a different permission. So I can create two federated identities. So when the user will log in via the organizational credentials, then he will get certain set of permissions and abilities to be done on the application, or maybe the whole interface will be different for that user. Whereas when the guest logs in via Gmail, he can only access and can see his dashboard. Suppose say if it is an e-commerce website, then the same application can be logged in by a Amazon agent. He'll be able to see much details more than you. You will be only able to see the details of your own account where you can log in via the Gmail into that application. Like this, you can create the Cognito.
So guys, this was our expert from Team K21 Academy, and if in case you missed upon any concept or if you want to dive deeper into the concepts, then we have something really special for you. We have our free class on Amazon AWS Solution Architect Certification for Beginners. Under this free class, you'll be learning about why and who should learn AWS, cloud services, deployment models, and AWS services as well. And the most important part is you'll be getting hands-on labs, job opportunities, along with Docker and Kubernetes in AWS, and amazing stuff. So if you want to register for this free class, all you have to do is just log on to your browser and type k21academy.com/AWS SA02. And after that, you'll be seeing this kind of interface. You just have to click on book your free seat now, select your event date, add your name, your email address, your phone number, and click on yes, save my seat. And after that, you'll be seeing this kind of page. You just have to save this link on the extreme right, add it to your calendars, and I'll see you in the free class. Till then, keep learning.